Back in the writer's room here with the guys from NHL.com. Adam, I'm starting with you on this one. 40 through 25. You okay with how things shake out as far as the rankings go?
I am, and I know, you know, one of the discussion points is going to be Seth Jones versus Roman Josi, where they rank. And to me, I like where they are. I'm a big Seth Jones fan. I have been, you know, unlike a lot of these guys, I cover the draft a lot. So I see these guys before they get to the NHL, and I start watching them. And, you know, how they look as a 17-year-old and 18-year-old, and you sort of project. And Jones, you know, watching him as a 17, 18-year-old, he projected to be a number one defenseman, an elite defenseman. And I think that's just exactly the path he's traveled. To me, he's one of the top defensemen in the league, top five defensemen in the league for sure. We did our internal awards balloting, and Jones, for me, was a Norris Trophy candidate. I think I had him either second or third this year. You know, he plays in every situation. He plays however many minutes you need him to play against whatever top-level competition you're going to play him against, and he's going to come out ahead. You know, he will help your team maintain possession. You know, he had a, you know, what was it? He played almost 22 minutes a game. You know, he was a plus 670 shot attempt. So that means the Blue Jackets had 670 more shots at 5-on-5 when he was on the ice than the opposition. That tells you what you need to know about the kind of player and the kind of defenseman Seth Jones is. And that's not to take anything away from Roman Josi. But if you're, you know, pegging those two guys and putting them this kind of a list, to me, Seth Jones would come out ahead. And that's, I like where he is on the list.
What about you guys? Any debate for you guys? Yeah. Seth Jones ahead of Roman Josi?
I mean, I'd put him the other way. I think you really split hairs at that point. But for me, with Josi, he does everything. And the one knock people will make on him is he's surrounded by a lot of top-end talent. He's got PK Subban. And he's got Ekholm. He's got Ryan Ellis, who they just signed to a new contract and showed how important he was to the team with the money they gave him. But I think Roman was the guy that drove that ship before PK came. Everybody forgets that there was a Nashville before PK came, yeah. And that they were good.
Yeah,
and,
really
and,
good.
And they were really good. And I think because of the flair that PK has, that sometimes the basic defending that Roman Josi is able to do gets lost a little bit. It's kind of the conversation that we've had about a lot of different teams that have two players at the same position who are really good. You have two good centers, which one kind of gets lost in the shuffle because the other one is so brilliant. But there's more to hockey than being brilliant. And I think Roman Josi, when it comes to the fundamentals and the things that you need a defenseman to do, is the best one on that team. And they are an elite team. So to me, therefore, he's one of the best defensemen in the game.
We haven't seen PK Subban on the list just yet. So in your mind, would you have Roman Josi higher than PK Subban?
I would.
Just because you like the steady Eddie approach, huh?
I do, and he's done it for a long time. And I just, you know, when you talk to people with that team, there's never an instant where they put him over the boards and they hold their breath.
Yeah.
And I don't know that that's the case with PK. He's a great defenseman. He does so many things well. He's won a Norris Trophy. He's been in that conversation. But I do think that they pair him with guys that can protect him when he plays that high percentage game. And I think Roman can produce the same kind of offense, maybe a little bit less, without having to play that high risk game. He's a low risk, high reward guy, I think.
What do you think, Brian?
I want to know this. Why is Barkov ahead of Phil Kessel? Honestly, Phil Kessel is a three-time 80-point guy, point-per-game player in the Stanley Cup playoffs, two-time Stanley Cup champion. All the knocks that have come with Phil Kessel, that he's not a big-time player and he doesn't care and he's out of shape and all this stuff, and all the guy does is go out there and produce all the time.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, I'll tell you why he's behind him.
Please.
Because Alexander Barkov is a center. He's Florida's most important player. They missed the playoffs by a point this year. They would have been in the lottery without him, I think, because he does so much for them. That guy, do you know who plays the most in the league as a forward? It's Anze Kopitar, who's up to MVP. You know who plays 1 second less than him a game? Alexander Barkov. He determines what happens with his team every day. Who determines what happens with the Penguins every day? Crosby, Malkin, Kessel, Chris Letang. All those guys.
Right.
Like, again, it's the argument that we just had. He's kind of lost in a forest of giant redwoods. He's a very good redwood, but he's lost in a forest of other ones. Barkov isn't. Barkov's the one that you look up at and you go, wow, does that tree ever stop growing? And that's why he's ahead of him. He just has more impact on the game than Phil Kessel can. Not that he does, that he can.
What do you
to
think?
Me.
I'm, Kessel has a whole lot more help than Barkov does?
I'm with Sean. I think Barkov clearly should be ahead of Kessel for a lot of the same reasons. He's a center. He's so much better defensively. He affects the game more. And if you look at points per game, career points per game, if I asked you who averages more points per game at even strength, Phil Kessel or Alexander Barkov, who would you say?
Oh, come on. But Phil Kessel's, look at his resume.
Okay, but wait. But it's 0.54. It's exactly the same. So you're talking Kessel with who he has played with throughout his career versus Barkov, who he has played with throughout his career, and you would say Kessel's had better teammates, but they're averaging the same amount of production at even strength, when that's, you know, really telling to me who, you know, what level of player you are. To me, Barkov, all the things he does in the middle, all the ice time he plays in all situations, he's a center. To me, I think
it's... And he's still evolving, too. I'm not trying Barkov and, here. He's going to be on this list for a really long time.
It's not an A or B situation, but if you're ranking them, who's the top player and who is more of a top player, to me, I'm voting Barkov ahead of Kessel.
And here's the other thing for me is not only is it a lot of minutes, it's all the hard minutes that Florida plays. Let's not forget, one of the reasons that Phil Kessel's been so good with the Penguins is he's been spotted in different places. He's allowed to play third line minutes. And you pick your poison as a defensive team. Do I use my best guys against Crosby? Do I use my best guys against Malkin? I don't use them against Kessel, right? So he's always getting the second or third pair. Barkov is their major threat. He's drawing every big guy, center, top D pair, and he's producing at the same level that Phil Kessel is.
Terrific.
So that's my argument.
For me, Phil Kessel is still just a little bit ahead.
I like what you said. We're splitting hairs at this point.
Yes.
40 through 25. Everybody's got great hair, by the way.